Howdy folks, and I was going to be doing a World of Warships video today, but well, then this happened, so World of Tanks it is. This is another one of those games that I am really going to have to apologise in advance for, because you just know that as soon as everybody sees this on YouTube, they're going to be trying the same thing when they end up on Redshire. What are you talking about, Jingles? Watch and learn, watch and learn. This is the postman in the Batchat 25T, and he's in a Batchat platoon with Morpheus tank, and that's him there, in the Batchat up ahead. They're on Redshire, and obviously it's a tier 10 match. And these two guys are going to be doing something I've never seen happen before on Redshire, but as a result of this video going up onto YouTube, I'm probably sure we're going to be seeing it a heck of a lot more often. And for that I can only apologise. Hello, what's going on here? Okay. If at first you don't succeed, try again. We're going to switch to the perspective of Morpheus tank here rather than the postman because, well, Morpheus is a little bit more initially successful at getting up onto this patch of higher ground than the postman who, well, as you can see, the postman almost, no, nearly, no, he's not quite made it, has he? Whereas Morpheus is already up there and the postman's going to have to go around again, so... While the postman is struggling to make it up, let's see what Morpheus tank is doing up there. So here's Morpheus tank's successful attempt to get up onto the hill, and you can see how he does it. He needs something quick and manoeuvrable to just ride the crest of the ridge there and then pull a hard turn at the end once you're onto the level ground, which is what the postman was trying and failing to do the first, well, two times. Whereas Morpheus tank just made it look easy. So, providing you have a tank that's fast and manoeuvrable enough, you don't need the assistance of anybody else to get up here. But what good can you do while you are up here? Well, we're going to see. This position is of course 100% completely useless unless the enemy team make a concerted push around the eastern end of the map, as they are doing over here. Let's go and see what the postman's up to, while Morpheus waits for targets to appear. Come on, postman, you can do it. Second time lucky. And no, not quite. Oh well, never mind. Take them around again, class leader. He's going to have another go. He's nothing if not persistent. Over there you can see the Waffenträger Panzer IV, who's attempting to commit suicide by enemy tank, as the postman lines up for his third attempt. And... Oh, yes, I think he's done it. Okay, right, so what the hell is that Waffenträger Panzer IV doing up there? Does he not realise he's in a very thinly armoured tank destroyer? In that position, the best he can hope to do is get one shot off and then die, and it didn't look like he even got one shot off. I don't know, maybe he just didn't like the matchmaking. Meanwhile, Morpheus tank already farming damage on the T-57 Heavy. That's the Jagdpanzer E-100 over there. Has already lost almost all of his health and had his tracks blown off. The Centurion Action 10 in serious trouble as the IS-7 comes around the corner. And yeah, Object 252 as well. Now, I dare say that a lot of you are going to be arguing, as Morpheus pulls back to reload and the postman takes over, that if the two Batchats hadn't taken this position and had instead been down there getting stuck in with the rest of their team, that their team wouldn't have folded over there as quickly as they do. You are of course entirely free to make that argument, but you'd be wrong. Have a look at the amount of health remaining on the enemy tanks down there, and don't forget they have artillery support as well, as the Jagdpanzer E-100 found out the hard way. Look at the amount of damage that a Batchat can do with one magazine loaded and its drum, and you will pretty soon come to the conclusion that the only thing that would have happened if those two guys had been down there with the rest of the team is that they'd be dead too. I mean, well, the best case scenario right now would be that both Postman and Morpheus would have lost a lot of health. Some of those enemy tanks may have died. A lot of them would probably be on lower health than they are now, but Morpheus and Postman would both be running away and reloading while being shot at by a whole bunch of enemy tanks and tank destroyers, not to mention the enemy artillery. At least from up here, they're able to do damage without losing any health in the meantime. And remember, the Batchat, like all autoloader tanks, is much more dangerous the longer it can survive. Don't forget, at the start of a battle, there are not a whole lot of targets available on the enemy team that a Batchat is able to take out from full health to nothing in one load of its magazine. As the battle progresses and more tanks have taken damage, suddenly the health pools don't look quite as intimidating, and the Batchat can take out an enemy tank in one go, often without taking any damage in return, because of the fast-firing autoloader. And so the primary consideration for any Batchat player at the start of a game of World of Tanks should always be to conserve what health they have rather than trading it in duels with tanks that they cannot actually kill, and conserve their health for the end of the game, when they get into fights with tanks that they can actually kill. And that's exactly what the two of them are doing, albeit from a very unconventional position. And while that Centurion Action 10 down there has played a great game, the only reason he's still alive is because Morpheus and the Postman are up here. And because they're staggering their reloads, they're keeping up a constant stream of fire, so that there's never a gap in the support fire coming down from this hill, which has allowed those guys to get around without getting shot at and finish off the Centurion. And it was only the Type 61 working his way around to the rear that broke the stalemate and allowed them to finish that Centurion off. And he paid for it with his life. Of course, Morpheus' tank got spotted at that point, and the Jaegeroo down there emptied his pockets at him and loaded the skill, because obviously, you know, 300mm of penetration isn't enough in a Jaegeroo. You have to have 420mm of penetration to deal with Centurions and Batchats, don't you? Still, it's his money. It's up to him what he does with it. So, what's going on in the grander scheme of things here in this battle? It's not looking too good, is it? They've lost more tanks than the enemy, although only two. But tactically, they're in serious trouble. The entire team is backed up into the top northern end of the map, with enemy tanks closing in from all sides. Morpheus only has two shots left in his drum. That one unbelievably bounced. And the S-tank has disappeared, so he backs up as the postman arrives with the full magazine ready to go and pulls back for a reload, while putting himself in a position to try to spot any further enemy tanks working their way around. The postman, now sitting on the hilltop with clear lines of fire and a full magazine, not quite quick enough, well, he was never going to be able to save the friendly S-tank down there as an enemy S-tank and an Object 140 charge in, but he is going to punish that S-tank and start putting some shots into the Object 140 with the two remaining shells in his drum. Round's complete, time to pull back. And yes, he did get spotted, and no, he didn't hang around waiting for Sixth Sense to tell him he'd been spotted, which is why those shots miss, and he's able to pull back into safety and reload. Meanwhile, Morpheus' tank waiting to reload and sitting here on 607 health after getting bitch-slapped by the Jaegeroo's premium ammunition, looking for the shot at the Object 140, who's in cover behind the wreck of the STB-1, switches fire to the FE-4202 just as he disappears from view, does finally get the shot at the Object 140 and takes him out. One shot fired, four remaining. Still plenty of enemy targets around. And there are only the three of them left on the team. Morpheus, Postman, and the S-Tank down in the valley below. And it's around about now that the Postman spots the IS-7 again. See, rather than just pulling back and hiding behind cover to reload, he pulled back and hid behind a bush to reload so he could still do some spotting for the team while he was replenishing his ammunition. However, nobody has particularly good shots at that IS-7, and so he does manage to survive for the moment. Morpheus keeping an eye on the flank, and more importantly, the cap circle. There's absolutely no danger that they're going to lose to being capped from this position. They've got shots on anything that wanders into the cap circle. IS-7 pops up again, but it's not a great angle, and he is partially in cover. So Morpheus switches to the FE-4202 instead, lands a good hit. Three shots remaining before he has to reload, and Postman is also putting some fire into the 4202, but it's ineffective. The Jaegeroo pops up again, but the angle is not good. He wouldn't do any damage to him from this angle. But there's the IS-7, and he's a one-shot kill, so Morpheus takes the shot, but Postman just beats him to the punch. With two rounds remaining, Postman pulls back. Yes, he did get spotted. He does not want to get shot at by the Jaegeroo and suffer the same fate as Morpheus over there, so he goes for a reload, while Morpheus expends his last two rounds of ammunition, ineffectively, against the Jaegeroo. The S-Tank is now dead, and they're both reloading at the same time for the first time in this game. But just because you're reloading doesn't mean you can't do anything. And so, while he's reloading, the Postman puts himself into a spot where he can keep an eye on what that pesky Jaegeroo is up to. And there he is. Now, the Jaegeroo isn't stupid. He's keeping his lower glacis hidden. He's keeping his frontal armour to where he knows these two Batchats are, so they're not going to be able to do a huge amount to him, although Morpheus does take a shot, but doesn't do any damage. And instantly pulls back because, yep, he got spotted. But what about the FE-4202? The Jaeger, who isn't the only tank on the enemy team. He's had plenty of time while these two guys pull back to reload in order to relocate. And there he is. He's no longer cowering behind the farmhouse. He's attempting to cap. And he's about to regret that very hasty decision, as they both pump shot after shot into him in very short order. And it's actually the blind shot from Morpheus that finishes him off. Four enemy tanks remaining. Let's not forget, one of them's artillery, and we haven't seen an awful lot of attention from the artillery so far, have we? Which is kind of surprising. It's not like these two guys haven't been getting spotted. But with absolutely nothing else to shoot at, you can guarantee that artillery is going to be ranged in on the top of this hill, just waiting for these two guys to get spotted again. So they're going to have to be very, very careful. Now the postman still has three shots remaining. And he's vacated the hilltop spotting position and given it back to Morpheus, who is busy reloading. The postman's determined to do some damage to this Jaegeru, but the Jaegeru is being very, very careful. He's not really giving him much to shoot at. The lower glacis is covered up. He's keeping the angles tight. He's not really giving them shots at the side of the casement. Oh, wait. No, no, not quite. Maybe the turret roof? No, not at that angle. Oh, oh, there it is. Finally, some damage done to the Jaegeru. But he got spotted. And there's a hit from the charioteer. We'd forgotten about him, hadn't we? But it's not really the charioteer we need to be concerned about at this point, is it? It's that 212A. And yep, there it is, and yep, that one missed. So, huge sigh of relief there from the postman. But what the hell is Morpheus' tank doing? What is he doing down there? Well, since the postman's reloading, let's go and take a look. I think that what we're about to see here is actually Morpheus screwing up. I don't think he intended to end up where he ended up. I thought he was just coming down to this spot here, which is actually kind of sneaky. Plenty of trees he can knock over and use as concealment, and try to get some flanking shots into the Jaegeru over there, but I think he screwed up and went slightly further than he had meant to, as you can kind of see him scrambling, trying to get back up there, but it's just not going to happen. And unfortunately, he gets spotted. And yep, there's the shot from the Jaegeru. And you can kind of see his thought processes here. He thinks, can I make it back up? No, I can't make it back up. I'm down here, I'm committed, I'm going to have to go for it. So that's exactly what he does. And he has to get into the cover of that rock there before the Jaegeru crests the ridge. And he makes it in there alive, but he cannot play chicken with the Jaegeru with the amount of health he has remaining. Meanwhile, back on the hilltop, Postman is waiting to reload. And look at that target. Just look at that target. But the gun is still loading. He could have finished him there and then. But hang on a second. As long as the Jaegeru stays in that position, the turret roof is easily penetrated. Jaegeru down. And he got spotted, and he is obviously going to have to manoeuvre to avoid taking hits from the artillery, but the Jaegeru is down, and that's just opened up a whole bunch of possibilities. For one thing, Morpheus is no longer pinned down behind this rock, waiting for artillery to kill him. Postman takes the Jaegeru out. Morpheus does not immediately break cover and give artillery a clear shot at him. Instead, he waits until he's no longer being spotted by the dead Jaegeru, and then he makes a break for it. With his magazine fully reloaded, and just artillery, and two tier 8 tanks left to kill. Now watch how they work together as they cover each other in an effort to locate and eliminate that Carnarvon and that charioteer. Postman's busy reloading at the moment, so Morpheus is taking no chances. He's tucked in behind that rock, nice and safe, nobody's spotting him. And now he's reloaded. Normally you'd expect the tank with most of the health remaining to be the one taking the risks, but, well, Morpheus, even though he has the lower health, ended up down there whether he wanted to or not, so he's the one doing the actual scouting, as the postman sits up here, ready to cover him, as he heads over to the ridge overlooking the friendly cap circle in an effort to flush out that Carnarvon and that charioteer. There's a slight brown alert moment here as Morpheus, crossing open ground, gets spotted with only 600 health remaining, but he doesn't hang around and, oh, hello, I think we have spotted the Carnarvon. And Postman caps him instantly, and oh look, there's the charioteer. And Morpheus caps him instantly, which just leaves the 212 remaining. And he hasn't even taken a shot. At this stage, of course, no point whatsoever in the postman remaining on top of the hill, so he, very carefully, because it wouldn't do to to wreck your tank by leaping off the hill like a young gazelle. Instead, you know, looks after his health. He may still need it. The 212 might get lucky. And they're going to... Well, the 212's got to be sweating at this point, aren't you? What are the chances of him pulling off a win now? He might still be able to do it if they weren't too Batchats hunting him. I mean, the postman's got 3 shots loaded and ready to go. Morpheus has got 4 shots loaded and ready to go. He can shotgun one of them without too much difficulty, you know, if he's any good and if he's lucky, but he's not going to kill them both. Between the two of them, they've got 7 rounds of ammunition loaded and ready to go, and it only takes 2 to kill a 212. That thing only has about 480 health. And these shots do 390 average damage, so, yeah. One of them has 5 kills, one of them has 4 kills. It would be nice if they could both finish with 5 kills each. Postman here has 5 kills, there's the 212. 390 average damage, he can afford to farm some damage on him, and leave the kill to Morpheus. Boom, headshot. 10 kills between them, brothers in arms. So, 10 kills and almost 9,000 damage between the two of them, but that's only good enough for a second class mastery badge in the Batchat. So what do you think, anyway, using the hill and that position in Redshire from the northern spawn? Is that an exploit, or is it creative use of game mechanics? I'm sure you'll all have your own opinions on that subject. And once again, I do apologise, by the way, if you find yourself on the Redshire map after this video goes up, and you're in the northern spawn, and your whole team tries to scramble up onto the top of that hill. It's not my fault, I didn't make them do it. I merely opened their minds to the possibilities. Yeah, alright, it's my fault. Anyway, nevertheless, I hope you enjoyed today's video, and as always, take care, and I'll catch you next time.